piercing the profile of an often impenetrable Western Australian soil. This delver is doing its job.
But this orange clay, fantastic stuff. You know, this is just changes the soil overnight, basically.
The Mickle family has worked this country for 20 years, 140 kilometres east of Esperance. Duplex soils delivering mostly solid results, but non-wetting issues are constraint.
Get on top of this problem we've got here.
Yep. Well, duplex soils, generally what we're targeting to delve is anywhere with sort of 20 centimetres of that lighter sandier type soil over the top of the clays. We've got a range of different clays. We have that nice yellow orange dome clay through to some harsher grey clays.
GRDC, with research partners DAFWA and the Southeast Premium Wheat Growers Association, are supporting trials into soil amelioration from Geraldton through to Esperance.
At Meckering and Mora, the trials are mainly looking at clay spreading and also the incorporation of that clay, whereas here we're probably more concentrating on the delving side of things.
And this delver has been tailor-made by Ian Mickle.
Ian's the brains behind the whole thing. He's the one that's constructed the machine from the bits of steel that come in the rack to he even does the operation on it still now. So he's extremely critical to this operation for me.
There are two issues on the go: penetration of water and roots.
The beauty of this project is that it's looking at ways in which we can overcome both constraints in the one soil type.
The delver digs deep at two levels, 40 and 60 centimetres, decompacting subsoil and unearthing clods of dome clay, the profile clearly illustrating the constraint.
We can see that roots tend not to go vertically through this dome, they tend to go horizontally.
Delving has delivered for the Mickles in the past, but their participation in the trial is all about getting the science right, especially incorporation.
Once we do the passing with the delving, we normally come back and we incorporate with the cross working at 90 degrees to the delve lines with a grizzly offset disc. We're still trying to work out if that's the best. We're not sure if we're getting the incorporation down deep enough.
Delving leaves the soil in a very rough condition.
And you can see how much of a ridge is created from the delve. It's a severe impact on the soil type.
So comparing implements and their incorporation effect is a feature of the trial.
All right, David, this is the footage we took the other day when we did the incorporation of the trial. You know, we've got the spading on one side. Now we've got the offset disc going through, running straight across those delve lines. You look at the way that's actually mixing those clays in nicely. And not only that, it's breaking up those big lumps so that we're able to spread that clay evenly through that topsoil.
Yield benefits can be significant.
I am hoping we're going to see a good 500 kilos plus improvement in where we've done the delving and the incorporation properly.
Wherever the delve has been, the crop's always significantly better. The heads are longer, there's a lot more potential yield there, and 99 times out of 100, the crop probably is yielding twice it is in the inter-row.
Delving is also about half the cost of clay spreading as long as clay is within 50 centimetres of the surface. It's labour-intensive, but the Mickles are convinced the long-lasting results are well worth the time and effort.
It's a simple principle. If we do it once and do it well, we're not going to have to come back and do it again. I suppose farming is almost one big trial. So we're using the chance to get into this is really it's a case of confirming to us and giving us that scientific background that we're running down the right path with the delving.